Hey, scientist! Last time I saw you, the sun was going down and the day turned to night. Now the sun is rising again and it's becoming morning. I wonder what makes the sky change from day to night and back again each day. It looks like the sun is moving, but I have a feeling something else is going on. We'll need to investigate what is happening between the Earth and the sun. That's tricky to do since we're on the Earth. I think I'll need to create something to help us see what's happening. I'll be right back. We've already learned that the sun shines its light on the Earth from 90 million miles away. The light travels really far to get here. See how it shines on this side of our planet? But look at the other side of the Earth back here. The sun's light doesn't shine here. It's in shadow. One side of the Earth can't be dark all the time, right? So what's happening? Check it out. I made this clay sculpture of the Earth, and we can use a flashlight to represent the sun's light. Ah, the Earth is actually moving all the time. The Earth rotates or spins in a full circle, kind of like the way a merry-go-round spins around its center. Wait, I can't feel the Earth rotating. Can you? Oh, Mia says that's because it spins very slowly. It makes one full rotation or spins in one circle once every 24 hours or one full day. How would you move if you wanted to rotate in one circle over a whole day? Pretty slowly, right? The sun, on the other hand, doesn't move at all. So if the Earth is moving, but the sun is still, the change in the light we get must be caused by the Earth spinning. Let's say we live right here, and we are in direct sunlight. That means it's midday. At midday, the sun appears to be directly above us. That's because our part of the Earth is turned directly toward the sun. Now, watch what happens as the Earth turns. See how our flag is moving away from the sun toward the shadow side? What could be happening in the sky right now? This is when the sun appears to go down. When we move into the sun's shadow, the sun is setting and the day turns to night. Nighttime lasts about as long as daytime because we are facing away from the sun for one half of the Earth's rotation. Now our flag is moving out of the sun's shadow back into the light. What time of day do you think this is? Take a moment to pause and make a prediction. Then we'll watch what happens when you get back. When our area moves into the light, the sun appears to rise in the sky. It's morning. As we continue to turn toward the sun appears to move higher and higher in the sky. Once it reaches the very top of the sky, it's time to move away from the sun again. Hang on a minute. My friend Justin is in another part of the world right now, right here, where the purple flag is. If it's midday where we are by the red flag, what time of day is it where Justin is at the purple flag? Take a minute to think about it, and we'll check when you get back. If you said that it's nighttime where the purple flag is, you were right. We are here in direct sunlight, so it's the middle of the day. Is there any sunlight by the purple flag in the part of the Earth where Justin is? Nope. This side of the Earth is facing away from the sun. It's the middle of the night for Justin. So when our part of the earth is facing the sun, it's daytime. When we're turned away from the sun, we have nighttime. And every part of the earth has a different amount of sunlight at the same time, depending on which way the earth is facing. It's so amazing how the rotation of the earth gives us night and day. Thanks for your help today, scientists. Keep creating, and I'll see you next time in the science studio. Hey, hey.